Which one of the following correctly identifies the order of Lorentz-Bronsted acids and bases in the above reaction? So our reaction is HCO3 minus plus HC2O4 minus to give us H2CO3 plus C2O4 2 minus. So if we look at HCO3 minus in the reaction or in the products, we have H2CO3 plus, meaning that this HCO3 minus has gained a proton or has received a proton, making it our base, and having H2CO3 plus as our conjugate acid. And that means that HC2O4 minus will have to be our acid, leaving us with C2O4 2 minus as our conjugate base. Therefore, the order will be base, acid, acid, base. And we have that in letter B. Let's look at 1.2. It says, which one of the following species cannot act as a Bronsted-Lowry acid and a Bronsted-Lowry base? If you look at the first option that we have, which is letter A, it's HC3COOH. And we all know that this is an acid, and an acid can never act as a base. Therefore, our answer to 1.2 will automatically be letter A. 1.3 says, the compound which will react with sodium hydroxide in a neutralization reaction is, for a neutralization reaction, we need an acid and a base, and we know that sodium hydroxide is a base. So in the options that we have, the first option is KOH, the second one is CaCO3, and the fourth one is C2O42 minus the third one. And the third one is C2O42 minus. And the last one is CH3COOH. By looking at these options that we have, we will realize that the fourth option that we have, which is CH3COOH, is an acid. Therefore, our answer will be letter D, and that is because for the neutralization reaction, we need to have the sodium hydroxide, which is a base, and an acid, which will be CH3COO4. 1.4. It says, when sulfuric acid reacts with water, it ionizes in two steps, as shown in the two balance equations below. The first one is H2SO4 plus H2O to give us H3O plus Q. And the second one is Q plus H2O to give us H3O plus R. So we are required to find what Q and R is. So in the first equation or the first reaction, we have H2SO4 plus H2O to give us H3O plus Q. So we all know that in a reaction, what's in the left shall also be in the right. So here on the left, we have H2SO4 and H2O. And on the right, we have H3O plus, meaning that H2O has received one proton from H2SO4. And that means that these two here on the hydrogen will be removed, and we'll be left with one hydrogen on the H2SO4. And we will be left with HSO4 minus, having that as our Q. So in the second reaction, we have Q, which is HSO4 minus plus H2O to give us H3O plus plus R. And we know that what's on the left must also be on the right. So on the left, we have H2O, and on the right, we have H3O plus, meaning that the H2O has accepted a proton from HSO4 minus to give us H3O plus, meaning that this hydrogen, which is on the HSO4 minus, will be lost here, or the proton, this HSO4 minus will donate a proton, and so we will be left with SO4 2 minus, and that will be our R. So therefore, if we look at the options that we have, option A, it says our Q is SO4 2 minus, which is not correct, and option B says our Q is HSO4 minus, which is fine. And so does C. And letter D says our Q is HSO4 2 minus, which is incorrect. And so we will have to consider B and C. And for our R, option B says our R is SO4 2 minus. And letter B says our R is SO4 minus, which is incorrect. And therefore, our answer will be C. Let's look at 1.5 says consider the incomplete chemical reaction below, which is X plus 2HNO3 to give us CaNO3 2 plus water plus carbon dioxide. So to find the value of X, we have to make sure that mass is conserved. What's on the left should be equal to what's on the right. So on the left-hand side, we have two hydrogen, which we do have on the right-hand side. And we have two nitrogens, which we do have on the right-hand side. And we have six oxygens, which on the right, we have six here. And we have one here, and we have two on the carbon dioxide, leaving us with nine oxygens. So on the left hand side, on the right hand side, we also have carbon dioxide and calcium, which is not there yet on the left hand side. So we know that our X should somehow have calcium, carbon, and oxygen. So we have one calcium on the right hand side, meaning that we should have one calcium on the left. So calcium is fine. And then we have one carbon on the right, meaning that we should have one carbon on the left. And on the right, we have nine oxygens, and on the left, we have six. And the difference between that is three, meaning that for the value of X, we should have three oxygens. So that will leave us with CaCO3. And that is option D. So therefore, the answer to 1.5 is D. Let's move on to question number 2. 2.1 says, consider the following acid-base reaction. We have HCO3 minus plus NH3 to give us CO3 2 minus plus NH4 plus. 2.1.1 says define an acid in terms of Lorentz-Bronsted theory. And acid is a proton donor. So we'll move on to 2.1.2, which says write down the formula of the two acids in the above reaction. Let's look at our reaction, and let's consider NH3 first. So on the left hand side, we have NH3, and on the right, we have NH4+. Sorry, let me take this 4 down, put it here. On the right hand side, we have NH4+, meaning that our NH3 has rather accepted a proton, and therefore NH3 will be our base and NH4 plus will be our conjugate acid. And then if we look at HCO3 minus, on the left hand side we have HCO3 minus, but on the right we have CO32 minus, meaning that the HCO3 minus has rather lost a proton and will be left with CO32 minus, leaving this HCO3 minus as our acid and CO32 minus as our conjugate base. Therefore, the formula of the two bases in the above reaction will be HCO3 minus and NH4 plus. Let's move on to 2.1.3. It says, define the term ampholyte. So ampholyte is a substance that can act as both acid and base. Let's look at 2.1.4, and it says, write down the formula of an ampholyte in the above reaction. So in our reaction, we have HCO3 minus and NH3. And we all know that there's nothing such as NH2 minus. So therefore, this NH3 can never be a base. But let's look at HCO3 minus and add it with water. So we will have HCO3 minus plus our water to give us H2CO3 plus OH minus. And here in this reaction, we'll be able to see that this HCO3 minus has received or has accepted a proton to give us H2CO3, meaning that it can act as both acid and base. And therefore, our answer to 2.1.4 will be HCO3 minus. 2.1.5 says, write down a balanced chemical reaction to show how the ampholyte named in question 2.1.4 above reacts with water, in which water acts as an acid. So we are going to have HCO3 minus plus H2O to give us something. But here we've been told that water will act as an acid, meaning that it will donate a proton. So therefore, we are going to have H2CO3 plus OH minus. So let's go to 2.2. And in 2.2, it says CO32 minus in the above reaction is reacted with 20 centimeter cubed of 0.2 mole per decimeter cubed hydrochloric acid according to the following balanced equation. 2.2.1 says, write down a reason why Cl is referred to as a base. And if we look at our chemical reaction, we can see that on the left hand side we have HCl and on the right we have Cl minus. So there we can see that HCl has donated its proton to CO32 minus to give us HCO3 minus, meaning that our HCl is our acid, and therefore what's left when the proton is donated will be Cl minus, which will be our conjugate base. And that is why we refer to Cl minus as a base. Let's look at 2.2.2. It says, calculate the number of moles of hydrochloric acid reacted. Let's look at what we have. We have the volume of the hydrochloric acid, which is 20 centimeter cubed. We have V equals 20 centimeter cubed. Let me correct that there. And we also have the concentration, which is 0.2 moles per decimeter cubed. So it says calculate the number of moles of hydrochloric acid reacted. So number of moles is equals to concentration multiplied by volume, coming from C equals N over V, and then cross multiply. Therefore, N will be equal to C times V. So our volume there is 20 centimeter cubed, but we do not calculate it as it is in centimeter cubed. We rather convert it to decimeter cubed, and for that we will have to divide it by 1000. So it will be 20 divided by 1000 multiplied by our volume, which multiplied by our concentration, which is 0.2. So we will be left with our number of moles being 0.004 mole. Question 3 says, two acid-base reactions are shown in the chemical equations below. The first one is NH3 plus water to give us NH4 plus plus OH minus. And then the second one is HPO4 2 minus plus water to give us PO4 3 minus plus H3O plus. 3.1.1 says, define a base according to Arrhenius' theory. A base is a substance that produces hydroxide ions when dissolved in water. Let's go to 3.1.2. It says, a conjugate ion of OH in reaction 1. So for our reaction 1, we have NH3 plus water to give us NH4 plus OH minus. So if we look at this water here, we will see that it has lost a proton and has donated it to NH3 to give us NH4. And what is left when the water donates a proton is OH minus. So that will leave us having water as a conjugate acid of OH minus. So therefore, our answer will be H2O. Let's move to 3.1.3. It says a conjugate base of HPO4 2 minus in reaction number 2. So in reaction number 2, we have HPO4 2 minus plus H2O to give us PO4 3 minus plus H3O plus. So 3.1.3 requires us to write a formula of a conjugate base of PHO4 2 minus in this reaction. So if we look at our reaction, on the left hand side we have HPO4 2 minus, and on the right hand side we have PO4 3 minus, and we will see that HPO4 2 minus has rather donated its proton to H2O to give us H3O4. Therefore, HPO4 2 minus will be our acid. And what is left when this acid donates its proton is PO4 3 minus. And therefore, PO4 3 minus will be left as a conjugate base of HPO4 2 minus. So this will be our base. And therefore, our answer to 3.1.3 will be PO4 3 minus. Let's move to 3.1.4. Methyl orange indicator is added to the mixture in reaction 1 above at the completion of the reaction. The color change of methyl orange indicator in acidic and basic solution is shown in the table below. For the color in acidic solution is red and the color in basic solution is yellow. 3.1.4 says define the term acid-base indicator, and that is a weak acid or a weak base which color changes as the hydrogen ion concentration or the OH minus ion concentration in a solution changes. 3.1.5, it says what is the color of the indicator in the reaction mixture? Give a reason for your answer. Let me write down our reaction, and that is NH3 plus H2O to give us NH4 plus OH minus. And therefore, the indicator will turn yellow. And that will be because we have a solution that contains OH minus ions. 3.2. And we have CH3COOH added with H2O. And that will give us what? So if we look at this, we'll see that it is an acid, and an acid always donate a proton. Therefore, this will donate its proton and leave us with CH3COO minus plus, and this will have to be a base and receive or accept a proton. So we will have H3O plus. 4.1. It says the Bronsted-Lowry and Arrhenius theories are used to define acids and base. 4.1.1 says define a base according to Bronsted-Lowry theory. And a base is a proton acceptor. Let's move to 4.1.2. It says consider the following chemical reactions. We have reaction A, B, and reaction C. So from the reactions A, B, and C, write down. 4.1.2 says the equation that illustrates Arrhenius' theory. And the equation that illustrates Arrhenius' theory must have either hydrogen ion or OH minus or hydronium ion. So the first equation has neither of those, and also the second equation, but equation C has H plus, and therefore our answer to 4.1.2 will be C. 4.1.3 says a substance that can act as an ampholyte. And if we look at reaction A, we have water, which can obviously act as an ampholyte. But in equation B, no C, we do not have water acting as an acid or a base. So we'll pass that and we'll go to equation B and C. On equation B, we have HSO4 minus, and so do we in equation C. So in equation B, you will see that this HSO4 minus has accepted a proton to give us H2SO4. And there, because it has accepted a proton, it will be our base. And in equation C, you will see that HSO4 has rather lost a proton or donated a proton to give us SO42 minus. And that means that our HSO4 minus will be the substance that can act as an ampholyte. So our answer to 4.1.3 will be HSO4 minus. Let's move on to 4.1.4. A conjugate acid base pair in reaction C. So if we look at reaction C, we'll see that we have HSO4 minus, which has clearly donated its proton to give us SO42 minus. So what donates a proton is an acid, meaning that our HSO4 minus is our acid, and the conjugate base will be SO42 minus, because that is what's left on the acid when it has donated. So our pair will be HSO4 minus and SO42 minus. Let's move to 4.2. 4.2 says grade 11 learners uses two steps to react sodium carbonate with concentrated sulfuric acid in step 1 and in step 2. The reaction occurs according to the following balanced equation: Na2CO3 plus H2CO4 to give us Na2SO4 plus H2O plus CO2. So 4.2.1 says define acid according to Arrhenius' theory. So an acid according to Arrhenius' theory will be a substance that produces hydrogen ions or hydronium ions when dissolved in water. Let's look at 4.2.2. 4.2.2 says the concentration of Na2CO3 in the standard solution. So for the concentration, we will need the number of moles and also the volume of the Na2CO3. So for the number of moles, we do not have, but in the given information, we have the mass of the Na2CO3 crystals and also the volume. So the mass that we've been given is 5.13 grams and the volume is 250 centimeter cubed, which is equivalent to 0.25 decimeter cubed. So for concentration, we can say concentration is also equal to the mass divided by molar mass all over the volume. And we know that mass divided by molar mass is equal to number of moles. So this whole thing is equivalent to mass divided by molar mass multiplied by volume. So that is the equation that we're going to use to calculate the concentration of Na2CO3. So the mass that we've been given is 5.13 grams and we will divide that by the molar mass. How do we calculate the molar mass? We add all the atomic masses of Na multiplied by 2 and C, and also the atomic mass of oxygen multiplied by 3, and that will give us a sum of 106. So we'll have 106 multiplied by our volume, which is 0.25, and if you tap that in your calculator, you will have 0.194 mole per decimeter cubed as our concentration. That is 0.194 mole per decimeter cubed. So 4.2.3, which is our last question, says the number of moles of H2SO4 reacted. The ratio of Na2SO3, let me write that down. Na2SO3 is to H2SO4. Looking at the balancing coefficient, is 1:1. So therefore, the number of moles of Na2SO3 will be equal to the number of moles of H2SO4. So the number of moles of H2SO4 will be the concentration of Na2CO3 multiplied by its volume, and that will be 0.194 multiplied by 0.25, and that will give you an answer of 0.049 mole.